anyone who dares to create can call themselves an artist. And I, a long time ago, started creating various things in my life. Probably started with rudimentary things like pieces of wood. I built tree forts and maybe some simple furniture. And then started to do more complex things. And one day, while working on a building project, I was playing with some aluminum flashing, and I decided to make a shark. And I made a handful of them now, I think seven. And this is actually one right here that is about to be revisited for the first time. It is now April 2017, and Piper wants the ball to be thrown. But this shark was made by me in 2009, and I made it specifically for my brother here in Florida, Michael Cronin, in Satellite Beach. And he's had it outside, and there were a couple things that I did with it where I didn't use stainless steel. You see here, this is rusted through, and some of these screws in the back are rusted down through here and here. And then up on the underside, we have some of the similar kind of things. So what I need to do is replace those screws and actually change this hardware right here. Here's another one of the sharks that I've made hanging up here in Melbourne, Florida, outside my mom's house. And you can see right here where I have a different type of connection using the crushed aluminum grommet on the end of some stainless steel cable, as opposed to what was done here, some ferrous metal, obviously not stainless steel eye hooks that have rusted and luckily didn't rust through. This one over here is just about had it. I don't know that it can handle much more stress. And I think it'll probably just break it apart right with my hand, just like that. So these things I'm gonna work on and replace. And you can see right here, KAC 2009. And I'll put a 2017 on there also to update that I've amended this particular one. This one I did actually 2 years ago, in October 2014. And it looks really good. It's a little Art Nouveau, a little non-realistic in its shape, where the body is not doesn't have any sort of fat rounded section in the middle that it really needs to show a shark-like body. This one I've got the fat roundedness, but it's a little toward the front. I actually had to move this aft because I need to get, you know, when they're hanging outside, the axis point is going to be in a certain place, and you need the majority of the vertical planes of the animal behind that access point so it will turn, you know, like a weather vane and always point up into the wind. That's the key, is getting it to point up into the wind. So there's the whole reason for access points and how much you want behind that certain central. So, and the dorsal is one thing that I can control, because you can kind of look at it and see like, oh yeah, I could see how you might want it a little further forward. And we'll see if we can do something about that and get it. I don't know that I'll adjust the position. That may be too much. Anyway, so that's just an example of art that I made. And I would encourage anybody to do anything, create anything, for good reasons. You know, don't create like the Fourth Reich or something like that. That would probably not be the best thing to create. And I think somebody's already working on that. So get yourself a fresh project and make some art.